Don't you just wish you could test drive your house before you buy it? I mean, you come in, take a look at everything, it looks beautiful, you're excited to move in, but then noisy, nosy neighbors come out of the woodwork, peeping over your fence and driving you crazy. Well, unfortunately, you can't test drive a house and refund it when you find out that your neighbors are kind of driving you crazy, but there are things that you can do using landscaping that will help you. So today we're going to be talking about Sierra's yard, and she lives in the Pacific Northwest, and she's got neighbors in the back and on the side that are just totally ruining her dreams of a beautiful, unique landscape. My name is Amy. I'm from prettypurpledoor.com, and that's exactly what I do. I try to help home gardeners create landscapes that are uniquely you and solve some of those landscaping problems that you have. So let's get into Sierra's consult and start to figure out what I would do if I were her. And hopefully, no matter where you live, this will help you too. Hi, Sierra. I'm here to help you with your noisy and nosy neighbors. It appears that you have both and situation. So I took a look at all of your pictures and sort of the satellite view of your home just to get an idea of the size and shape of your yard. And this is the satellite view I pulled. So I'm guessing that this is where the camera people are. And then in the back here, I can see how that would be an issue. It looks great now, like you were saying, because some of the trees are filled in. But in the winter, that's gonna all go away. I have a similar issue at my house, actually, in the backyard along the property line. There was all forsythia planted, which I would never recommend anyone planting forsythia because they're such a huge maintenance nightmare for me, and I'm always pruning them. But it fills in so nice in the spring and summer, but then they just go to nothing, and all their leaves drop in the winter, and I can just see right into my neighbor's like house. It's really weird. So the way that I've done that is by adding evergreen privacy hedges. So that would probably be something I would recommend to you. But I have a few options here. So right here, I think that this picture here is a great option for you because it's like a fence on top of a fence. So you already have a fence there, but clearly it's not high enough. So first, check local regulations and make sure that there's no height situation. You didn't mention anything like that when you wrote me in, so I'm assuming that there's no HOA or any sort of height restriction situation. But if there's not, say this was your fence here, you could add posts going up and then add almost like a second layer of fencing above that fence. So this is like a lattice, which I think is kind of a cool option because it's not like totally blocking like 100%. You could still kind of see through a little bit, but it's gonna block the majority. Another option, since you do have a patio, I guess it would be the north side. I'm like so bad with directions, but I'm trying to follow. On the side of the house, it looks like you have a patio. So a situation that might work for that is if you installed some sort of bent like a bench seating around that, and you can use that as like a seating area to eat and put the table in the center. And then from there you can build a structure that's actually these are like kind of like wrought iron panels, which I think are really cool and would help with privacy and blocking the neighbor. And also would give you some privacy in the winter months as well. And what I really like about this is that with these built-in seats, it's perfect. And then you can move the table or have a fire pit or have your parents sleeping there, because I know you said that your parents like to sleep outside. So this could also be kind of a little bit of a covered area where it can do double duty. A little bit cheaper option. And a more flexible option because it wouldn't be a permanent structure, but you could do something like this with blinds. These are some sort of like bamboo or something, I think. Looks like they have them strung on the top and along the sides, but you could pull them down and raise them back up so You can see out, but you can block certain things. A really flexible option. It looks like it's almost like on PVC pipe or something. I think this might be kind of a neat option for you as well. And finally, this is just a decking option. I wanted to do this at my house. At one point, I was going to put a deck in and I was going to just have them make the posts run a little bit higher and then I could put panels in. So once you have the privacy taken care of in this situation, you could add another layer. So these are my arborvitae. I have emerald green arborvitaes as a privacy screen. I only have a chain link fence. I didn't have the money. I had to fix a lot of things in the house. And I have a dog, so I just needed it fenced. And instead of going back and redoing the fence years later, I planted these rows of arborvitae. It looks a lot different now, even than this picture. I have an arbor up now, and I'm starting to plant in front of the arborvitae. So I think this might be a good option for you as well, either in the back or the side. It would cover up these areas of lattice, and it's also gonna help you with the sound barrier between them and you. You could always plant a row of evergreens as a backbone. Evergreens will stay nice all winter. They will protect you all winter. They will block noise all winter. And then in front of that, you can start to add some of the native plantings that you like as well. It's kind of a both and. You can do any of these options, and you can also in front of that do this, or you could just do the arborvitae. And these are emerald green. They should get 12 feet eventually. I think mine are about 10 now, but they do have this like pyramidal shape. So in your situation, you'd probably be able to see them through these little like V areas here. There's different privacy hedging that you can use too, though, and different arborvitae. Green giant is very, very large, very fast growing. So just take a look and see if there's anything in your area that grows nice, or maybe you can find something native and evergreen that you can use. My other thoughts here were I think that you have space for everything that you want to do. So I don't really see much going on here other than this looks like that patio area I was talking about. So I consider this a wide yard. Let me just actually if I rotate this, because it's more wide than square. So there's kind of the outline there. So a lot of times people will split this sort of thing in two pieces. That was a really bad drawing, by the way, I'm sorry. But you can split it in two. So if you wanted your lawn area here for your little boy, and then over here would be your cottage garden area. Looks like I'm kind of splitting it this way, or I would almost like maybe even extend that patio out. So this would be your patio, and then you'd have the fencing right here to hide those neighbors. And then maybe your cottage garden area would be like so, all in here. And I know you have the pets over here, but this is another fencing area or arborvitae area. And then that still leaves you with this like nice space to for lawn here for your little boy to play. And so you can kind of get best of both. And you know, you could still fill in with plantings, fill in, just make sure that you have a nice little path up here to your shed and fill in. And then here you would just need this is my bed. I don't know if they sleep on the ground or what's going on with your parents sleeping outside. I think that's hilarious, but that's what I would do. So I hope that helps, and thanks so much for sending me all of your information. And hopefully you can get back in touch with me and let me know if we've solved your issues with your noisy, nosy neighbors. I also have a link. I will send it to you and I'll put it in the description of this video as well if anyone's following along and wants to see the blog post I wrote about creating privacy for second story neighbors. So I had a lot of questions about how to block people that are on a second story or have an upper deck next door. So I think a lot of those solutions will work for your situation as well.